Derbyshire Artsword.
What's on?
Welcome to Derbyshire Artsword, a podcast focusing on the Derbyshire art scene in association with Belper Arts Festival. This week's Artsword is sponsored by the Ritz Cinema Belper. To find out their latest screenings, visit www.ritz-belper.co.uk and stay tuned for Ritz Recommends with Ashley Franklin. If you'd like to sponsor a show or feature in one, please go to artsword.co.uk. First off, we're over in Chesterfield, and with Easter fast approaching, it's time for a pantomime. On Sunday the 25th of March at 3pm and at 7pm, Chesterfield's Pomegranate Theatre stages Alice in Wonderland. Alice is enjoying her picnic when she sees the most curious of sights, a white rabbit talking to himself. Following the rabbit down the rabbit hole, she finds herself in a fantastical wonderland inhabited by the Dame, Duchess Dolly, the Bonkers Mad Hatter, the Evil Queen of Hearts and her henchmen Tweedledum and Tweedledee. Will Alice find her way back, or will she find true love in Wonderland? Contact the Pomegranate Theatre box office for tickets which are priced from £16.50. Prepare ye the way of the Lord when Inspiration Theatre Company brings Godspell to the Playhouse Theatre, Hasland. Based on the Gospel according to Matthew, Godspell is the first musical theatre offering from composer Stephen Schwartz, who went on to write such well-known hits Wicked Pippin and Children of Eden. The show features a comedic troupe of eccentric players who team up with Jesus to teach lessons in a new age through parables, games and tomfoolery. Godspell also features the international hit Day by Day, as well as an eclectic blend of songs ranging from pop to vaudeville, and it was the show that made David Essex a star. Godspell can be seen from the 27th to the 31st of March, and tickets are £12 from ticketsource.co.uk. After a two-year break, the Passion Play returns to Belper on Good Friday and the 30th of March. The community event has over 120 musicians, actors, singers and performers in this brand new production. The music featured is from This Man, an Easter oratorio by local composer Andy Val, with script by George Gunby and directed by Janice Richtoff, who has worked in Florida on several Passion Plays. The Walk of Witness begins outside the HSBC Bank at the bottom of King Street at 11am. The Passion Play will be staged in Belper St Peter's Church, with the performance scheduled to begin at 11:45. Admission is free. The brilliant Nicola McAuliffe stars as Miss Havisham in The Great Expectations at Buxton Opera House from the 3rd to the 7th of April. Peopled by some of Dickens' most colourful and memorable characters, and painted in rich, vivid colours across the vast landscape of people and locations, this stunning new version promises a powerful and theatrical telling of Dickens' universally loved masterpiece. Tickets are from £11 for children to £22 for adults, and are available through the Opera House box office and online. Now described by the New York Times as a gut-busting hit, Fawlty Towers meets Noises Off in the Olivia Award-winning smash hit comedy The Play That Goes Wrong. The Cornerly Polytechnic Drama Society are putting on a 1920s murder mystery, but as the title suggests, everything that can go wrong does. The accident-prone thespes battle on against all odds to reach their final curtain call. Hilarious results ensue. From the 3rd to the 7th of April, you can see The Play That Goes Wrong at Derby Theatre. Tickets are from £20.50 via the Derby Theatre box office and online. And finally, the Wirksworth Book Festival 2018 is on its way. From the 6th to the 9th of April, the Wirksworth Book Festival brings a whole host of activities, talks, performances and much more for adults and children. As always, there'll be a film for the kids on the Saturday morning at the wonderful Northern Light, a quiz on the Sunday night, and lots of things in between. For more details, go to wirksworthfestival.co.uk.
Derbyshire Artsword. The film review.
This is Ritz Recommends. Ashley Franklin previewing this week's films at the Belper Ritz Cinema. The film I, Tonya has been scheduled at just the right time in the wake of Alison Janney's supporting actress Oscar, following, it ought to be said, her BAFTA and Golden Globe. Margot Robbie was also nominated for Best Actress as the titular character in one of these unbelievable but true stories turned into a darkly comic picture, as we follow the spiralling ice skating career of Tonya Harding, though fame turned into infamy through her association with an ill-conceived attack on Tonya's skating rival, Nancy Kerrigan. I, Tonya is a no-holds-barred biopic of a coarse-talking woman from the wrong side of the tracks, competing in a sport that likes its champions to be princesses on ice. Here, with her career on the rise, Tonya skates back onto the ice to confront one of the judges after receiving lower scores than she expected after competing.
4.8.
How do I get a fair shot here? Because I'm up at 5 every morning working my ass off. Does someone want to just tell me to my face you're never going to give me the scores I deserve?
This is how it's done. Some of these girls have paid their dues.
I don't give a shit. I outskated them today.
We also judge on presentation.
Well, you know what? If you can come up with $5,000 for a costume for me, then I won't have to make one. Till then, just stay out of my face.
Maybe you're just not as good as you think. Maybe you should pick another sport.
I, Tonya is an irreverent and piercing portrayal of Harding's career. And although a comedy, it goes to some dark places, showing the physical abuse she suffered at the hands of her husband and the verbal abuse she endured from her mother, played brilliantly by Alison Janney. Expect to both revel in and wince at her acid tongue and monstrous behaviour in a film that has been described as Goodfellas on Ice. I, Tonya, on All This Week. Lady Bird comes to the screen on the back of 5 Oscar nominations, including Best Picture, a great testament to a modestly budgeted independent film about a 17-year-old's coming of age. Inspired by the memories of Greta Gerwig, who earned nominations for Best Director and Original Screenplay, Saoirse Ronan, who won Best Actress at the Golden Globes as well as gaining an Oscar nomination, plays the title character, a precocious 17-year-old on the brink of adulthood who has a loving but turbulent relationship with her strong-willed mother, played by another Oscar nominee, Laurie Metcalf. This opening scene in the car tells you everything about their close but fraught relationship, where Mum's words bring Lady Bird to suddenly eject herself from the vehicle.
I want to go where culture is, like
New
York,
did I raise such a
or at least
snob.
Connecticut or New Hampshire,
well,
where writers live in the
get
woods.
Get into those schools anyway.
Mom!
You can't even pass your driver's test.
Because you wouldn't let me practice
the way
enough.
That you work, or the way that you don't work, you're not even worth state tuition, Christine.
My name is Lady Bird.
Well, actually, it's not, and it's ridiculous.
Call me Lady Bird like
Christine.
You said you would.
You should just go to City College. You know, with your work ethic, just go to City College and then to jail, and then back to City College, and then maybe you'd learn to pull yourself up and not expect everybody to do everything.
Lady Bird is a drama that has been hugely praised for the authentic way it explores the gulf between childhood and adulthood, with especial praise for the fact that although Gerwig has created a dozen key characters, they are all vividly drawn. Within this drama, too, is humour, poignancy and sharp-eyed social observation, with Saoirse Ronan at its beating heart, bringing us a flawed heroine who has been applauded by one critic for offering such an appealing mix of mischief, delinquency, naivety, defiance and precocious charm. That's Lady Bird on All This Week. Well, it's been a long wait, but we're back in plasticine heaven with Nick Park and Aardman. The creators of Wallace and Gromit bring us Early Man, a prehistoric comedy adventure. Mind you, it's always a long wait when Nick Park and co make a movie, because with clay animation, even when there are over 30 animators working on entirely separate scenes at the same time, each one is still only going to produce 5 seconds of action per week. And they couldn't shoot anything until the 23 different model makers had made 273 puppets over 2.5 years, with 3,000 interchangeable mouths crafted for the film's characters, all by hand, of course. Also, each one of the 60 trees produced for the Stone Age forest took a week to complete. As Nick Park said of his caveman film, it's been a mammoth production. but we wouldn't want it any other way, would we? You know from all the Aardman films we've enjoyed over the years that clay animation, married with Nick Park's very British humour, creates films of great charm and lovability, with unique and memorable characters too. And there's a star-studded British cast here as we follow the story of courageous caveman hero Doug, voiced by Eddie Redmayne, and his best friend Hognob, Nick Park himself, as they unite his tribe against a mighty enemy, Lord Nuth, voiced by Tom Hiddleston, who rules over the Bronze Age city. Other voices include Timothy Spall, who plays the tribal chief, as well as Mark Williams, Johnny Vegas, Richard Ayoade, and many more.
Chief! Whoa, 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 whoa. Time to go hunting!
Bit early, isn't it, Doug?
Right, grab a spear.
Oh, it's pointy.
Change your underpants today?
Yeah, changed them with dongle.
Never mind.
Shush, everyone. Attack!
Excellent.
The Edge of Stone is over. Long live the Edge of Bronze.
Hey!
Where have you been, the Stone Age?
I've got to save the tribe.
The arena's this way.
So throw your sticks and throw your stones, cause you ain't gonna break my bones.
Huh?
If I'm a sinner, then I don't be a
chief. A caveman?
A caveman?
You leave my tribe in peace.
How dare you?
Oh. I'll take him away and kill him.
Slowly. Ah, idiots.
If we win, we can have our valley back.
And if we don't beat them?
We'll spend the rest of our lives working down a mine.
No! What's a mine?
You're pretty brave, caveman. And stupid. Ooh, I can help.
Hognob, you stay. I don't want to attract attention.
Well, I think Peter Bradshaw of The Guardian hits the spot when he says that it's impossible not to laugh at the inspired silliness and charm of Nick Park's universe. Early Man, he continues, is a family film that doesn't just provide gags for adults and gags for children. It locates the adult's inner child and the child's inner adult. It's a treat. That's Early Man. This week's satellite screening on Tuesday is a celebration by the Royal Ballet to mark the centenary of Leonard Bernstein, one of the great American composers. Bernstein was very eclectic in his sources, drawing on jazz and modernism, the traditions of Jewish music, and the razzmatazz of Broadway musicals. We can thank him and Jerome Robbins for West Side Story. Because many of Bernstein's scores are so well suited to dance, the Royal Ballet decided to celebrate the dynamic range and rhythmical nature of his music with a triple bill that also reveals his diversity as a composer. One ballet is based on his choral work, Chichester Psalms, a second takes his violin concerto, Serenade, and the third is his distinctively American symphony number 2, The Age of Anxiety, which has the feel of musical theatre a la West Side Story. The three ballets have been highly commended, handsomely staged and superlatively danced, said one commentator. That's a Royal Opera House celebration of Leonard Bernstein, performed at Covent Garden this Tuesday at 7:15. Also on at the Ritz this week, Black Panther, a Marvel movie that's described as gripping, funny and full of spectacle. And there's another chance to see The Mercy, the true story of Donald Crowhurst's ill-fated journey in the Sunday Times Round the World Boat Race of 1968, starring Colin Firth and Rachel Weisz. Next week at the Ritz, we have Peter Rabbit, Woody Allen's Wonder Wheel, and the 1517 to Paris, Clint Eastwood's true story of American heroism where the heroes play themselves. This has been Ritz Recommends.
Derbyshire Artsword. Artsword. Director's Corner.
You claim to be the Christ, the Son of God, are you?
This is what you say. From now on, you will see the Son of God sitting at God's right hand.
I've heard enough. You deserve to die. As only the Romans can give the death penalty, we'll have to take it to the government. We'll take it to Pilate.
My name is Janice Richtoff. I'm originally from Florida, and I've been living in Belper for 4 years now. I've done a lot of youth ministry work, and in that youth ministry work, we've done a lot of plays and passion plays at our churches, at my church down in South Florida. And because of that, we started an acting troupe, an improv group, and it just developed into that. How I came to be directing the Belper Passion Play, that was a blessing. I'd heard that George was writing the play, and I spoke with the churches together in Belper and just offered my help. If there's anything I can help you with, I'd be happy to help in anything, whether it be sewing costumes or helping, again, in helping in any way possible. And you start meeting people, and then I met Anne Stratton from St. Peter's, and they introduced me to George, and we clicked. We had great conversations about who Jesus was and what kind of passion play this year. It would be more of the historical instead of the modern version from the previous years. And we just clicked, and then I'm directing the play, and I was like, okay, let's do this. It's going to be fun.
My son, I'm here with your brothers and sisters. You may not see eye to eye with everyone, but we are your family.
Whoever does the will of my father is my brother, sister, and mother. But right now you should go.
Why?
You'll see things no mother should see.
I know all a woman can suffer.
Then go. Go away.
No, I'm meant to be here.
Have they been to see you?
Yes.
Did they tell you I was mad?
They said that Satan was in you. Because of all the miracles, and because you declared you're the Son of God.
They were my family.
A prophet is never recognized by his own family.
What did you tell them?
I said that I could help you. If they'd let you come home.
I can't come home. God has set a mission for me to carry out, and it's bigger than what people can conceive.
We need each other.
We will always be together. I will never leave you nor forsake you.
I have watched you with tears in my eyes. Without you, men have no hope.
There will always be hope.
How?
I will always be here.
Fickle Jerusalem, how you loved him that day.
The previous passion plays were of modern dystopian society, but with the same story, a revolutionary changing people's minds about what true love is and forgiveness, and it was beautiful. But to do something new, we went back to the old, and that's what this year's is. Our play is based on the Passion Play. It is during Jesus, during Roman times, when Jesus was sacrificed in Jerusalem. So it's more historically correct. The Belper Passion Play is going to be happening on the 30th of March. It starts at the bottom of King Street. The actors will proceed or process up towards St. Peter's, and it depicts what Palm Sunday maybe would have been like. And that starts at 11, and then the performance in St. Peter's is at 11:45. The play alongside the performance of the original works from Anna DeWall from This Man Oratorio. Please come and enjoy a beautiful play, sharing the love of Christ, sharing everything that happened at that time with beautiful music.
Derbyshire Artsword. Spoken word.
Young Eric, a dog, and death. Behind our house there's fields, and some days I take my son off for a hike. What I say hike, it's more like a brisk walk. What I say brisk walk, it's more like a stroll. What I say stroll, it's more like a meander. To be honest, it's more to do with getting out of house, usually when Gate's baking. Don't get me wrong, I was a good cook, but I'm always in road. So last Thursday, I gets the cake tins out, and I thought, me sen, time to make me sen scarce. It were a nice day, so I took me backer and some papers, with idea of having a quiet smoke at top of hill. There's a bench, and you get smashing views down valley. If that's lucky, that can see Mrs. Orton having a shower. With that in mind, I settled down and lit up. It were at this point that I saw this bloke coming towards me. I squinted into the sun when he said, "Hey up, Judd." It were older Eric's eldest, young Eric. "How are you?" I said. He said, "How are all right?" "How are you?" And I says, "I'm all right." Having established we were both right, I noticed he'd got a greyhound with him. "Nice dog," I said. "Aye," he says. "Does he have a name?" I said. "Usain," Eric replied. The way it were behaving, it were more like insane. "I'm going to race him," Eric said. Now I couldn't see sense in that. No matter how hard he tried, young Eric were never going to beat a greyhound. I said to Eric he looked a bit tired, and he said he'd had a funny week. Turns out he were putting his daughter to bed last Friday, and she said her prayers, and I'll end her, "Rest in peace, Grandad." Following day, Grandad died. Saturday night, he put her to bed again, and she said her prayers, and she said, "Rest in peace, Grandma." Following day, Grandma died. By this stage, young Eric were thinking he could see into the future. Young Eric told his missus, and she said she thought it were coincidence. That night, young Eric puts daughter to bed, and she said her prayers. Young Eric were on landing when he heard her say, "Rest in peace, Daddy." Well, that threw him into a right panic. He run downstairs and told wife what he'd heard. She laughed and told him he were being daft. Monday, Eric goes off to work, and he's right whittled. He keeps his head down, but he keeps thinking that he's going to die. When clock ticks round to 5, he jumps in car and drives home. Very slowly and very carefully. He gets home and parks up, and he's right chuffed. He can't but laugh. Surely nought can happen now. Anyhow, he goes in house, full of joys of spring. Wife sitting on sofa, and young Eric bounds up to her side. "Look, look, I'm alive," he says. And that's when he notices his missus is sobbing. Young Eric puts his arm round her and says, "What's up, duck? She wipes her eyes and blows her nose and says, "Milkman's died."
Derbyshire Artsword.
Derwent Valley on demand.